How to convert B22 bayonet to E27 screw light bulb. Everyone knows this. This is a CCFL old type light bulb. You know, this the LEDs take over and their spaces, so LEDs are quite popular now. But sometime you get LEDs, especially in UK, you get LEDs with a screw type. You know, this is not this no use for the appliances for light fittings. This type of lights are useless. So how do we convert this to a bayonet type B22? First of all, we need this. We need this light, because this light's we don't need anymore this light. So we actually need this light. So how do we actually need this piece here, this piece. Earlier I opened one of them. Basically like this. What you do is actually use a lighter. Just heat up, keep heating, or just use the kitchen gas cooker and just, or use you can use a torch. Torch is ideal. You just heat up, heat all the way, and use a plier, and then just pull it. It will just come off easily. But before you open there, we need to open this right here, because we need wires. We need this wires long. We need this wires long. So the if you open straight here, this wire maybe break off from this end. So this is useless. We can't use it. So how do we do is, you get a flat screwdriver, just push in, and just keep pushing in like this. And most of the lights will open. Some of them with the glue, you just need to break the glue, or just open it, or open the already earlier. So just that just opens like this. There's a couple of wire. Just break this two wires, and that's it. And after, you know, we need this piece. And I just go to get a torch, or get a lighter if you have. But some lighters make some black marks on it. But torch is ideal. You just use a torch, and then just pull it with the plier, and that will just come off. Or you, this will just come off. Once you take it off, you just there's two pin. One basically just lays to the side of it, just like this. Just lay down side of it, and just bend it all the way down. This is the one. This is the one, the first one. Second one is a bit tricky, because the second one shouldn't contact with this one, because that will be the one pin, and one pin connects to the this cover, this shield. And the second pin, and you can use a plier, sorry, tweezers, and then just make it like a screw, spring, sorry. So when you do like this, basically like this, and just make this right in the middle, because the LEDs, not like older type of halogen lights, they don't use a lot of current, so this will be, even if it will touch, I'll be absolutely fine. There's no fire hazard, because this is completely shielded. It's inside, even if you know, if there's not really great contact. But as I say, LEDs, no need, you know, like, they don't use a lot of current, like LEDs, like sort of halogens. So to level of this has to be in that level, right? Sorry, right, this level I'm trying to show on the camera. So it has to be, so it's this pin in the middle, it has to be that, you know, that about this, that level. So when we screw this in, because this side is wider, so this can go, screw in to into this, which I already done before. So you just force a bit, and voila, that's it. Like this. Now we can try it. Some older type light sockets, where the bulb goes. Some older type light sockets are metal. If the socket is metal, do not try this, because when you put one of the pin into this shield, this may goes alive. So when you put this on the socket, the whole light fitting, all appliance will become alive if any metals on it. So do not try on the metal sockets. Most important thing with this is this, the metal spring kind of wire, has to be right in the middle, not too high, not too low. There has to be on this line, the bottom line, on this, has to be on this line, because when we put the ball pen, it goes, you know, right about there. When you try this, if it didn't work, always turn the power off, and make sure the lampshade is not metal. If the lampshade, the socket is a metal, do not try this at all. But the modern type of light sockets are plastic shielded, so I will be fine with them. Once you put the light on, if any metal on the lampshade, check with the pen, or with the meter, tester, and before you touch anything. This is really not recommended, but it works. Thank you for today. I see you probably another project another time. Bye bye.